Let's take a quick tour of DaVinci Resolve. Here, if you're familiar with iMovie, you'll notice it's set up very similarly. You have your media pool, which is up here at the top left corner. That's where your videos are going to live. You have your video view, and you have your timeline below. Now, down here at the bottom is how you navigate different sections of DaVinci Resolve. Here in the front, you've got your media. Here is your cut view. Here is your edit view. And this magical wand view is your effects view, where you can add special effects and that sort of thing. The color view is where you can play around with the color and the lighting. And you can add music with the fair light view there. And that's also an editing audio editor built into DaVinci Resolve, which can be handy. I'm not typically using that for these virtual choir projects just because DaVinci is a hefty program and I only like to ask it to do my video. That's why I use Audacity for the audio. And once we finish the track, we'll move over to the render view there and save off the video. So let's head back over to the edit scene, which is where we're going to do most of our work. Certain windows can be removed by clicking certain buttons. You can move things around and play around with that. DaVinci is capable of a lot. We are going to talk about DaVinci Resolve in terms of editing virtual choir projects using the system that I've developed. It works, it's simple, it's easy to follow. You'll just want to click through each one of these videos and do exactly what I do, and I'll walk you through that process one step at a time. I will teach you in a couple of these modules how to add some special effects. They are not necessary. They are optional, but they may be of interest to you. And without further ado, my friends, let's go ahead and import some videos and get this virtual choir project on the roll.